of our Lord and good men already, from generation to generation, from age to age, you are.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Look upon your family, Lord, that through the chastening effects of bodily discipline, our minds may be radiant in your presence with the strength of our yearning for you through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down, and they do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats. So shall be my word that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial psalm. From all their distress, God rescues the just. From all their distress, God rescues the just. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. From all their distress, God rescues the just. Look to him, that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress, he saved him. From all their distress, God rescues the just. The Lord has eyes for the just and ears for their cry. The Lord confronts the evildoers to destroy remembrance of them from the earth. From all their distress, God rescues the just. When the just cry out, the Lord hears them, and from all their distress, he rescues them. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit, he saves. From all their distress, the Lord rescues the just. Praise and honor to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Praise and honor to you, Lord Jesus Christ. One does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God. Praise and honor to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory
to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "In praying, do not babble like the pagans who think they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them. Your Father knows what you need before you ask Him. This is how you are to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. If you forgive men their transgressions, your heavenly Father will forgive you. But if you do not forgive men, neither will your Father forgive your transgressions." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Messages from God. Strange. I've had conversations with people where this idea has come up in recent days. And I had read something by Bishop Robert Barron also that touched on this idea of messages from 2,000 years ago. I can't say that I hear voices or even have dreams that God is speaking to me, but certainly this message that we read about in the gospel today is a message from the Son of God, not from, you know, this very important prayer that has been repeated so many times. It's not from some guru, genius, who figured out how to pray to God, but from God's Son. It couldn't be more perfect. And it couldn't be more of a direct message for us these 2,000 years later. What a miracle this is, if we just stop to think about it. And amazingly, and Bishop Barron, this was his idea that gave it a little twist from what I had been thinking, but I thought, man, he said that this prayer connects us, links us with all the great figures in Christian history, from Peter and Paul, apostles, to Augustine, Thomas Aquinas, Francis of Assisi, Mother Teresa, John Paul II, all the way up to today, linked all of us saying this prayer, repeating it for 2,000 years. Now, certainly our Lord performed so many miracles 2,000 years ago, what eventually developed was a book full of messages for us, the Bible. All the recorded events of his life is filled with so much meaning for us, and it's in layers, and you have to think about it. Of course, that's what he wanted of us, to think about what he said and did, to work through it and find the messages there for us. They're so important, these messages. But hold that thought for just a moment about the messages from 2,000 years ago. Think about today. What's happening today? Communications today are so different. For, you know, someone from 2,000 years ago, they would think, I'm on another planet. It's, you know, we've got television, video, and on our phones, and on our tablets, and on this and that. And We have printed media, even though it's old and going out, you still can get a newspaper that's filled with stuff happening every day. And we are just bombarded with information and ideas and concepts, ideologies. And, you know, I couldn't help but worry about some of that because it impacts us in various ways. One, I think it distracts us from perhaps some of the things we need to be concerned about. God, for one. But then it also can manipulate us to some degree, even if it's not true, something we hear through media, through Facebook, or whatever. It may be repeated on the nightly news over and over. You know, even if it's not true, we may lean towards believing it, and it may be very subtle. And we have to be careful. Who's controlling these things? I can't say that I know the answer to all that. It has to be people in power, people with wealth, political machinery. But we need to remember that that has nothing to do with eternity, does it? The importance of all that stuff is just a flash here today, gone tomorrow. And let me step away from that thought for just a moment. There are four pillars of faith in the church, and I know you're aware of them. The Ten Commandments, the creeds, the seven sacraments, and of course, what we've been talking about, the Lord's Prayer. And it is the Lord's Prayer again, if I may repeat. He liked to repeat things so people remember, so sometimes I do that too. Learn from the best. It is one of the most important messages. Christ explained in the Lord's Prayer how he wanted us to communicate with him. I remember back when I was at studies, Father Tokars had something to say about the Lord's Prayer. He said, well, you know, that translation wasn't quite perfect, not quite accurate. And he may be right about that. He didn't go into detail. He mentioned a couple of things that weren't quite on target, like where it says cup, or the translation of the words also with you, different things like that that Father Tokars mentioned. And he's quite a scholar. But what I couldn't help but think then and now is that this message was so important. It's been around for 2,000 years. How many messages from today will be around for another 1,000 years? I would bet and pray and hope that Christ's message about communication will be here in 1,000 years, if mankind is still here on this earth. And the opportunities for us and for the people of 1,000 years from now, I tend to believe we'll be the same. We will have the same opportunities to move towards perfection. Prayer is part of that opportunity. I know that I've said it so many times, and you will recall what Saint Mother Teresa had to say about letting nothing come between you and Jesus. Certainly this prayer is one of the weapons that we have to ensure that nothing will come between us and Him, and for all the generations to follow. Peace be with you. For the whole Christian people, that in this sacred time they may be more abundantly nourished by every word that comes from the mouth of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our word.
For the whole world, that in lasting tranquility and peace our days may truly become the acceptable time of grace and salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our word.
For sinners and the neglectful, that in this time of reconciliation they may return to Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ourselves, that God may at last stir up in our hearts aversion for our sins, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to teach you the word, but I will say word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. through these mysteries, Lord, that by moderating earthly desires, we may learn to love the things of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Lord bless us, protect us from all evil, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.